Hey and welcome back. Today I'm going to reveal to you the secrets behind my project, The Film You Are Not Allowed to See. How it exposed a broken copyright law and how it exposed to me personally how badly YouTube treat creators. And I'll tell you how the film and my input changed YouTube for better. This is a story I've been putting off for over a year. 1.2 million people have seen this film, the film you're not supposed to watch, and I need to explain its secret history. There seems to be a number of confusions. First of all, the confusion over the title, The Film You Are Not Allowed to See. Let me explain its horrible history. So if you're a regular viewer to my channel, you probably know who I am. I'm a freelance media professional called Simon Holland, and I've worked in broadcast television since I was 20. I'm now 63, and I've earned a living working for major broadcasters, PBS, National Geographic, Discovery Channel, BBC, lots of people. And I was very pleased to be asked, hired to work on a science program made by the BBC in London called Scientists in Their Own Words. It's an occasional series using archive and looking at historic, very interesting science debates from history. This particular film was all about physics, and its central core, I thought, was the dispute between Fred Hoyle and Martin Ryle about the steady state or so-called Big Bang theory. That dispute, that debate is fascinating. And I'm going to go on as a second film to actually discuss what you as viewers think about how the universe came into existence. But today, I'm going to tell you this incredible journey, this incredible story of how I and this film changed YouTube. So, quick story about being a self-employed freelance broadcast TV person, or if you work in the movies, you'll know this story. Say you've done the makeup for a major film, say you've composed the music to The Matrix, or say you've edited a very fine BBC documentary. You need to share clips from the project that you've just worked on for future job offers. And that's a standard movies and TV industry thing to do. Plus, I wanted to share with you, the viewers on YouTube, this interesting debate about the origin of our universe. Because a lot of you probably don't watch the BBC. You might have missed the PBS program if you live in the United States. So I wanted to make it accessible to you, the YouTube audience, because I know you have interesting things to say about the origin of the universe. So I just wanted you to look at a clip. So I posted it to YouTube and immediately got a fatal copyright strike from YouTube via Google's legal office. So YouTube and Google, who own YouTube, make money by placing adverts on your films that you post and host on their site. If there's a copyright dispute, they still post adverts and they keep all the money. So I decided to make a very brave and bold move on behalf of myself and media workers in general. This, as a YouTube creator, is a very serious matter. If you win your claim, it's yours. If you lose your counterclaim, you get closed down. But I thought this was a fight worth fighting. So I got a scary letter from Google's legal department that says, "We recognize that you're countering their claim, and it's up to in the next 30 days, listen to this very carefully, 30 days to say whether they still believe it's their claim. And if so, your channel is shut. But if they don't make a claim in 30 days or drop the dispute, you win the right to show the film and all monetization during the dispute period." And the film really took off. It went from a couple of thousand up to nearly 100,000 viewers as you, as YouTube viewers, found the subject fascinating. And for 30 days it rocketed. So imagine a graph. So it was published and it went up to like 1,000 people, and then it went down to zero. Then there's 30 days, and then suddenly it was nearly 100,000 people, and now it's gone up to nearly 1 million. So there's a big part of that viewing figure that is completely missing, that Google kept the advertising revenue. So after 30 days, what happened? Never disputed my counterclaim. So I won. I wrote to YouTube and said, we haven't heard from them. Does that mean, under your terms and conditions, that I've won the case to show the film and to collect the money? And I heard nothing. It's very hard for creators to actually contact YouTube, but I went through their and eventually I got a response saying, yes, under your terms and conditions, as they didn't dispute your counterclaim, you have won. Whoopee-doo! I was so pleased for me, for other media workers, and potentially to get a rather large check, maybe a couple of thousand, maybe up to $5,000 for the missing viewing figures that were monetized, that Google kept. So I wrote back to the only people I had contact with and said, how do I get the money? But just like you, I went through all the YouTube terms and conditions, those pages that you don't normally read, and clicked that little checkbox to say I agreed them. And one of those terms and conditions says, if you win a dispute, you get paid. Well, YouTube, come on. I fulfilled your terms and conditions. Where's my check? So how exactly has YouTube improved? Well, they've done two things. One, they've started creator support, which is great. You can write to them at any time. And two, if you win a copyright dispute, any money which is due to you is paid in your normal monthly payments. And in part two, I'll explain to you why I'm not really Adam Savage, why I don't really need a dental plan, and how thousands of comments from people with deeply held religious views have completely changed the debate about the origin of the universe. I'm going to dive in and discuss who made the universe and why it's such a sticky issue. The truth is out there.